my body given for you. This is the cup that holds the blood of a new covenant. This is forgiveness, simple and true. This is the way that I have made for you. Before you eat, tell me what you see. He said, do this in remembrance of me. Do this in remembrance of me. This is the bread of life broken for you. This is the cup.
Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Saturday. Today is Saturday, May 11th, and tomorrow is Mother's Day. So happy Mother's Day to all of the women that mother us. And so I give thanks for the many mothers in my own life, and giving thanks for all of you as well. So good to be with you this morning. Today, that was Cheryl Kagi. Off of the very best of Cheryl Kagi's album, that was in remembrance of me. So I hope you enjoyed that. Today we're going to be looking at Luke 24, the part of the walk to the Emmaus road to Emmaus. So I'm specifically, I think I'm going to start in verse 30. So Luke 24, verse 30. And we're going to be talking about the most human and the most divine gesture. So good to be with all of you today. Let me say good morning, Donna and Janet. It's good to be with both of you today. Keeping you in prayer this morning. And Yolette and Susan, welcome. Praying for you today. Good morning, Ingrid. Good morning, Ingrid and Jerry. I'm glad you're both with us, praying for you this morning. And Al and Debbie, it's good to have you both here, keeping you in prayer today. Good morning, Barbara and Blanca. Glad you're with us, praying for you this morning. Good morning, Susan and Lynetta. I'm glad you're both here. And Lynetta will be praying for Jackson, lifting up his family. Praying for you as well, Susan. So, and Lynetta. Good morning, Susan Abubakar and Gloria. I'm glad you're both with us, praying for you this morning. And good morning, Sue and Genevieve. It's good to have you both here today, praying for you. And today I'm going to ask you to keep in prayer the family of Patty Zamore, whose memorial service will be this morning at 10. Just keep, especially keep Shaz and Carrie and their children in prayer. So, surrounding all of them today. Okay, so let's jump into Luke. It's going to be Luke 24:30 as you turn in your Bibles. My name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And it's good to start the day with each of you. This is going to be the last week that we're going to do it. So, next week is going to be my last week doing it, at least for now. We'll see as I transition into the new church, but for now, this week will be our last week together. So I'm glad to be able to start the day off with all of you. So let's take a look. Luke 24:30. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed, and broke it and gave it to them. And then their eyes were opened and they recognized him. And he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road and while he was opening the scriptures to us?" That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered there, and they were saying, "The Lord is risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. So our devotion today comes from Henry Nouwen's Bread for the Journey, and it is entitled "The Most Human and the Most Divine Gesture." He writes, "The two disciples whom Jesus joined on the road to Emmaus recognized him in the breaking of the bread. What is a more common, ordinary gesture than breaking bread? It may be the most human of all human gestures, a gesture of hospitality, of friendship, of care, and the desire to be together. Taking a loaf of bread, blessing it, breaking it, and giving it to those seated around the table signifies unity, community, and peace. When Jesus does this, he does the most ordinary as well as the most extraordinary. It is the most human as well as the most divine gesture. The great mystery is that this daily and most human gesture is the way that we recognize the presence of Christ among us. God becomes most present when we are most human. God becomes most present when we are most human. So I was thinking about the times that we break bread all the time. And often we call having a meal together, breaking bread with one another. There is something very powerful about the table, sitting down to a table, a meal. Jesus did it over and over again in the Gospels, especially in the Gospel of Luke. Jesus broke bread. There's something very powerful, very human, and very divine. But I was thinking about this last Thanksgiving. We had a service, an interfaith service. So it wasn't a Christian service. It was an interfaith service. And we sat around tables with our Muslim and our Jewish and our Christian brothers and sisters. And we broke bread. And we shared bread from different faiths. And what a powerful experience in a time where there felt as if there, and still feels as if unity is breaking, as if there is no unity, to gather around the table, to do the very simple thing of breaking bread with one another and saying that we want unity, we want to be one. We say at the communion table, we say there is one loaf because we are one. We are one. So I guess my question today for all of us is, who are we breaking bread with? Who are we sitting down to a meal with? Yesterday I had the chance to sit down to a meal with two different meals with people from the community where I will be going. And that was really nice to be able to break bread with them, to share in community with them. And I know that I'll be doing a whole lot more, as well as Pastor Myung will be coming and breaking bread at New Brunswick with his new church family. So this is important work, but an important way of blessing one another, of finding our unity, of sitting around a table and hearing the stories and seeing the things that connect and maybe sometimes disconnect, but that's okay too. It isn't so much that the table is perfect, but that we actually go and do it. So today, this week, who are you breaking bread with? Who are you going to sit and have a meal with? This upcoming week, as I look at my calendar, more and more people have asked to have a meal with me, which is really nice. Different people, clergy, colleagues, and members of the church, and all kinds of different people I'll be breaking bread with this week. But who are you breaking bread with? Who are you sitting down to a meal with that you might see Christ more fully? That you might encounter Christ in the midst of the breaking bread. Perhaps this is where we will find our wholeness, our unity. As we move into this time of prayer, we're praying for Jackson, praying for a special prayer. I mean, definitely praying for the Zamore family. I ask you pray for Patty Zamore's grandson, Kobe, whose mother passed away a few months ago. So now he is a double grief for this young man. So just pray for Kobe, pray for the whole family. Surround them with lots of love and prayer today. And who are you praying for? Who are you lifting up? I invite you to do that in the chat. Let's pray. God, we come today grateful for the many people in our lives that we get to sit and break bread with, for the tables in our lives, kitchen tables and community tables, for the table that you invite us to, where we are reminded that in you we are one. Forgive us, Lord, when we forget this so easily, when we get caught up in defining what is different instead of seeing our oneness in you. Thank you for inviting us back to the table, even when we don't deserve to be invited back. You invite us again and again, and you ask us to do the same, to break bread with one another, to invite those who we might normally not invite to come and to share a meal with us. Help us, Lord, in the breaking of the bread, to see you again, more fully, more perfectly, within one another. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Today, keeping in prayer Barbara's family, for Audrey and family. Of course, we're praying for Jackson. So lifting you all up in prayer, praying that you know this good news, that you, my friends, that God loves you. God loves you. And so do I. Have a blessed day. And I will see you. So tomorrow, we're going to be talking about the prayer that Jesus prays for his disciples in John's gospel. So I'm very excited for this message. So I don't know. I hope you can join us tomorrow at 11. We'll also be celebrating the gift of the mothers, the mothering that occurs in our life. So I hope you can be with us tomorrow at 11. Have a very blessed day, and I'll see you then. Bye, friends.